All right, January 25th. Good luck, Boogie.
Thank you, man.
The album soon comes.
Everything for sale.
Hello and welcome to Saturday TV. It's your boy DJ G7. We are back for another review. But before we start, do press the subscribe button and don't forget to press that bell. Also, we are uploading more and more videos now, more and more analysis videos, more and more reviews. They are coming. I've been blessed with time now, so fortunately, I can now pump into a channel. Right, let's get right on to the review now. Boogie. The one thing I love about Boogie is his basically attention to detail. I mean, when you listen to his mixtapes, the Thurs mixtapes that he had released part one and part two, you can see already the type of rapper he was already setting out to be. He was like he was really labeled as conscious rapper, which, in my opinion, I don't even know what conscious is. I mean, I can see why we're conscious, why it's called conscious now because of the turn up side of hip hop, but that's a conversation for another day. However, Boogie, on the other hand, he does pay attention to detail. He reminds me of one of those vintage rappers that just loves his territory as well as get as lyrically poignant as possible. Not like J. Cole, because J. Cole is more of a simplistic kind of storyteller, but he's a lot more. He will leave a lot of layers in a track for you to go and figure out later on, and that's what he's done in this album. It's no different. This album was an upgrade from his mixtape, and with this being his debut album, I was very, very impressed. I mean, I love the fact that he kept to the classic album style, not just a compilation of songs that you just grab and then throw into a playlist and then that's it. No, this one actually had an overall message, and the message in this album was exactly toxic relationships. And that's and you know, with an album this vulnerable, it's amazing in this climate, because that's all everyone's talking about, toxic relationships, how it can get like that, etc. But Boogie takes you through the hand and walks you through what happens when you're in that toxic relationship, when you do something wrong, when you end it, when you're out into the clubs after it, and then he threw inside in case you have a child, and then he threw also the family's reactions to this breakup and to the child, and there was a lot, and to end it with time, which kind of brought everything around full circle to pretty much symbolize a new him, now that time has passed, now that father time, now that time has passed, he's got a lot more to offer. Like, he's now learned a lot from those relationships, he's now learned a lot, and he can move away from it. That's what I loved about the storytelling in this. I gave it a 7.2 out of 8. Like, the storytelling in this was simply exquisite. I could not stop listening for 1 minute. And like, even though you moved on to the turn up tracks, like even though you had those tracks that are singles, like I believe the Soho track was one with Jid, he still stuck to the story. He still stuck to the fact that he's just recovering from a breakup, which the girl obviously took his phone in silent ride. It's escalated as the story goes on, and he's now left without a girlfriend, like, you know, without a woman. And now, like, it was completely exquisite for me. Like, I enjoyed it thoroughly. The lyrical content on this album, it was a lot better than what I actually heard from his mixtapes, from the Thurs mixtapes. He really, really stepped up. He had talents such as Jid and Eminem. Jid being like, you know, he's an upcoming rapper himself, so Jid does have a lot to prove. But you can see the differences between him and Jid. I mean, like, him and Jid, with Jid being a lot more aggressive and faster with his style, and then you can see how these two are not alike. I'm surprised why people say that they are alike, because when you compare these two at the same time, that like they really are different. Like Boogie can switch up his flow to make it slower, and he can make it faster. Like, but at the same time, he's not that aggressive. He's actually more on the laid back kind of side. He's actually more chilled. And that's what I love about him, because when you look at his interviews, when you look at how he conducts himself in the interviews, how he conducts himself in when he's talking to our people, like how he shows his family life. This is sipping through into his music, because that's exactly how it was in his album. It's very vulnerable. He was very free with it, and that's the one thing I loved about his album. Like, it allowed it to flow beautifully and effortlessly. I love the style he took it in. He didn't just stick to the boom baps. Like, I did hear a couple of I did hear a soulful side. Like, I love the different facets of styles that he presented on this project. I mean, we had the soulful side, we had the R&B side, where he's just becoming a lot more vulnerable with the track Life 95. This track alone was, in fact, peak on instrumentation. However, like, in terms of the style, this track was also to epitomize its range, its ideas, and this attention to detail was amazing. Like, and then you have Skydive, which was a more of a futuristic kind of R&B sound. In fact, it's just plain to say that he was able to offer a lot more than just a pure hip-hop album. When you listen to albums nowadays, it's just trap sounds. I mean, that's not to take anything away from trap. Trap, he has his place. I mean, even he experimented with trap sounds on this album. I believe it was Rainy Days, if I'm not mistaken, but he did experiment with trap as well. But the point I'm making is he was able to explore different type of instrumentation, bringing different styles to show his level of artistry, and he done it at such a high level that I was very impressed. That I gave him a 4 out of 5 for the flow and style. Now, like I mentioned earlier, with the instrumentation in Live 95, it was the peak, in my opinion. It was that was the best track to exemplify instrumentation. Not just that, also, but Silent Ride. Silent Ride, the instrumentation that was also really good. There was no real fault in that. I couldn't find any real fault. The track, however, that did stand out a lot for instrumentation, in my opinion, was Rainy Days. Like it had C1, who produced it. He has also worked with the likes of Kanye West. This wasn't actually a very bad production. It was actually very good. I gave it a 3.8 overall. I mean, even though it did have that kind of talent, that was the only talent on the roster. The other talents on it, like, you know, Kelek, which is his main producer, he produced every track, and he did say in the interviews that he like you know, that's his boy, that's the person that's been producing. He's a very good producer, and he did do well on this album. I do feel like he could have been a lot more versatile. He could have brought in other producers if he was able to bring C1 in, obviously with the influence of Eminem, who appeared in the track Rainy Days. If he was able to do that, I felt like he should have done that with some other tracks that needed it. But however, I don't think the instrumentation was the highlight of this album. The highlight was the storytelling, and I really believe that it was that good that it glossed over the what may have been lacking in the production department. So overall, like I said, I gave it a 3.8 out of 5 for the instrumentation. For the final scores, the scores added up to 21 out of 25, which if you divide both of them, it will add up to 84%, which is 8.4 out of 10. So, I mean, it's a great album. I highly recommend it. This is not his best. I know there's a lot more to come from him, but for this to be his debut album, I was ecstatic when I first heard it. Like, I just couldn't wait to tell everyone on my Instagram, on my Twitter about it, and I was like, get this album, and I'm recommending the same here. Listen to this album. It was a great self-reflective piece, and it really provided a lot more of an insight onto what goes on in toxic relationships, and, you know, and like there was a lot of character arc in there as well to show his own growth. Like, you see him, like, you know, he was even fighting to see, like, oh shoot, like, you know, like, he's seeing other women on the side. At the same time, he was like, he's like, no, I shouldn't be doing this, it's bad. And then you see him grow and grow and grow as the album went on. He starts to see the effect of his actions. You see, like, you know, there's so much from here that you can chew on, and that's what makes a great album to me. So in the end, this album is really, really highly recommended. I want to hear your thoughts on it. Let me know what you think in the comments below. Make sure you subscribe. Make sure you share this video. I am a new channel. We're trying to grow. We're trying to expand. I want this to become more of a community so that we can talk about albums like this and also different kind of breakdowns, analysis, etc. So thank you so much for rocking with us today, and see you on the next review. Peace.